Hi, everyone. Would be cool if my voice was deeper, but jokes aside, hi everyone. So yeah, I'm here. This is my face. It's been a while since my face has been in these videos and since I've actually just taken some time out to actually speak. But in any case, in this video, I just wanted to reflect on how my time in New Zealand has been. And yeah, it's been, I don't know how it's been, but you'll hear when I start talking. So I'm just going to speak about things that I've been finding easy and things that I've been finding difficult. So I'll start with things that I've been finding easy. Getting around, I normally use the Uber or the bus because, I mean, I use the bus back at home. So it hasn't really been anything new here. And I am glad for that. I'm glad that I'm literally just somebody that lives a plain, simple life. And for that reason, I am really finding it easy to get around using public transport. It's not a train smash at all for me. And there are people that keep asking me if I'm not considering getting a car at the moment because I don't have a big social circle. I still don't need a car because literally I go to work, I come back. And if I'm doing anything, I planned well in advance. And most of the things you get to do with people that have cars and that are willing to pick you up. So that hasn't been much of a challenge for me. For somebody that's highly dependent on their own cars, I guess being here would mean getting a car. Most people advise on getting a car, but I haven't yet felt the pressure to get a car. Like, I love the bus. I could just be in there and admiring fashion, just looking around, being able to actually take in like the views because I'm not the one driving. And but all in all, yeah, so getting by has been really easy. And food, because I'm not really particular with my food, but also I'm not somebody that explores food. I just eat so that my stomach is full, and I really just eat so that my stomach is full. So food also hasn't been a problem. I hear a lot of people saying they miss food from home. I don't. I'm just being honest, I don't. Once in a while, I'll feel like fed cakes. But it's like, even when I was at home, I only ate them once in a while. And there's still flour here and yeast and things, so I could make them if I wanted to. But it's not like something that's pressing on my heart. So I'm finding the food easy. I mean, there's bread. There's bread, there's eggs, there's milk, there's rice, there's chicken. So what more do I need? So the food hasn't really been hectic on me. There's a lot of Asian cuisine here. So if you love Asian food, you would be great. But I don't know, I'm good. Like, guys, I'm good. I'm good with my chicken. I'm good with... there's everything, actually, that you could need outside of, you know, particular food. I haven't seen tribe anywhere. And I haven't seen Sam. I haven't... but it doesn't matter with me because it's not things that I ate a lot back at home. So I'm finding the food easy. It's not really a train smash for me. And what's the other thing? Yeah, I don't know what other things are there that one literally needs. Church. So most churches here, most Christian churches are charismatic Christian churches, which is exactly like my church back at home. I used to go to CRC back in South Africa, which is great. And it's such a blessing to find the exact same feel of churches here in New Zealand. So that's also been great. And yeah, I'm just trying to think of other things that are there. Other things that are there. Yeah, church. And yeah. And also sharing, because I'm staying in a house with other people. It hasn't really been hectic. It has its challenges here and there, but you know what? It's good. I'm staying with good people, and some of the things are just small things. They're not big things. And I'm certain also I'm bringing a different dynamic to them also. So yeah, I mean, one of the people that I am so open to spending most of my time with is here in the house, and that is Aten. Aten is so cool. Aten is so cool, guys. Aten is so cool. He's like my photographer. And the second person is also Genie, that I get along with. And literally, actually, I get along with everybody. It's just that there are people that you connect with on a childish level. So this is the level on which I can connect with Genie and Atet. So that's great. But yeah, and there is like so much wisdom around the house, like finances and things like that. So it's really great. So yeah, those are the things that I'm finding a bit cool. And the things that for a short while were a bit of a challenge was work. I mean, being in a new environment where you don't know the machines, you've never worked with them before, in an environment where you have so many colleagues. And with many colleagues, unfortunately, comes different characters and different behaviors, and different attitudes. But I have to say, although I'm counting this as a challenge, I have really grown within the workspace in terms of my emotional intelligence and interpersonal skills, because the different colleagues have really just taught me to kind of be adaptive to different people and different circumstances. And I'm doing it so well, guys. I'm doing it so well. You know, some things I still take home overnight to get over, but most things I literally leave them at work, because I've just learned how to handle myself around different characters and different people. And I think I have really just grown so much as a person. With every encounter, I try to like unpack it, and always look at it from a positive perspective and give the person the benefit of the doubt and not always just assume the worst. So yeah, been a challenge, but I've really grown and I'm so grateful for that. And some of the things that I have to mention that are still a bit of a challenge is how I encounter or relate with white South Africans from back home. And I don't mean this in a bad way or anything, but I guess this is how you get to see how certain things just affected you, is when you are in a place where they're not supposed to affect you anymore, but they still are. Every time when somebody wants to introduce me to somebody from home, I kind of pull back a bit and I become scared. I'm scared if they're going to be happy to see me here, or if they're actually not happy to see me here. Because this is just the reality of things. And truth is, there are good people from back home that I hear that just have good intentions and don't have a problem with black people, never had back at home, never do here. But it's just something that is constantly at the back of my mind when I have to be introduced to a fellow South African. It's like, oh my goodness, chances are they're white, chances are they're Africans, chances are they left South Africa to escape people of my skin color. And truth is, although I'm in New Zealand, I'm still a black South African. So I always get scared of how them seeing me here is going to affect them. And for most people wanting to introduce me, because they don't know the dynamics, they're always so excited. It's like, oh, you know this other person from South Africa, and I'm like, oh, you do? Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, I'm excited to meet them. But truth is, I'm a bit scared. I'm still waiting to see how they look at me, because truth is, you can see even with that look, there's that look that tells and puts everything out on the table. So that is still a bit of a challenge. But the good side to it is that being in New Zealand, guys, literally puts you on the same level. On the same level where your qualifications are the only thing that speaks for you, not even the color of your skin. And I understand that New Zealand also has its own racial dynamics that they're dealing with the Maori people that went through something that could and I don't even want to say could be compared, but it could be referenced to what Black people went through in South Africa. And yeah, the government is trying to correct that. And but you know what? The South African story will always be different from the New Zealand story. And the New Zealand story will always be different from the South African story. But yeah, I just love how we're on the same level. You just need to get that qualification and, you know, work on your CV, and that will be literally the only thing that speaks for you. And the other good thing is just, I have to say this, that I just love people from the UK, and I just love people from, yeah. The English people are so good. They're so welcoming. They, I don't know, but so there's a few. Well, I can say there's a lot of them at work. And the fact that New Zealand is so diverse, guys, on so many levels. There's people from all over the world that are here. So at the end of the day, we're all foreigners beyond our skin color. You know, we're all foreigners. We're all striving. We're all trying to find our feet. And there's a sense of welcome because it's like people understand where you're coming from. They understand what it means for you to be here. They understand what it means for you to be finding your feet being here. So that's one of the good things that I've just found being here. And yeah, I'm learning to overcome, I guess, the trauma of being a Black South African, you know, and understanding that I'm here. And that's all in, it's not in the past because it's still my story to tell, but to say I don't have to worry about being as much as affected. Because if the next South African is uncomfortable with me being here, well, there's the next English person that is excited that I'm here. There's the next person from wherever that's glad that I'm here. So yeah, but it's a journey of growth. It's I'm excited because above all things I just find pleasure in growing. So that's what I'm achieving here. And yeah, the one thing also that I'm finding really difficult is, oh Heavenly Father, we ask that you come into just the field of dating in New Zealand, because it's just so chaotic, guys. It's, I feel like if you want to be, if you want a hoe, excuse the language, but if you just want to YOLO in the field of dating, you must come to New Zealand. Because it's just, it's wild. Like, it's really wild, guys. So you can just come here. Okay, the dating culture is different from, I'll say, from the Black community, as opposed to how it is here in New Zealand. I don't know how it is in the Indian community from back home, in the white community from back home, or in the colored community from back home. But with us, how we date is that once a guy pursues you, then you know they want to be with you. It's not a matter of we still testing waters. We test waters as we go, and if things don't work out, we'll break up. So here, testing waters means today I'll go out on a date with Sylvia, tomorrow I'll go out on a date with Portia, on Thursday I'll go out on a date with Palesa, on Saturday I'll go out on a date with Tipuo, and maybe I'll go for second round and third round. But as long as I haven't said to any of them, you are my girlfriend. There's no attachment, there's no nothing. But the problem is, by the third date, there's an expectation for sex. So it's just crazy. And the sex is supposed to conclude on whether or not you guys are vibing, you know. So I don't know what it would mean if this person would sleep with all five of you and vibe with all five of you. What would it then mean? But yeah, it's just, it's wild, guys. It's so wild. It's so wild. But I guess that deserves another video. But yeah, that's basically how things have been here in New Zealand. I think for more things, you can just ask me questions and then I can make videos on them. And yeah. Oh, also, guys, I'm gonna be on New Zealand TV. I'm gonna be on New Zealand's TV through a Coca-Cola advert wearing this jacket right here. So I'm excited about that. I'm gonna share it. Definitely, I'll share it here on YouTube. But otherwise, thank you for watching, guys, and just ask me questions so that I can create videos about them. So yeah, this is me, and until the next video, take care of yourselves. Happy New Year, and don't be scared. I know COVID is here, but don't be scared, guys. Still make those goals, still have those resolutions, still pursue those dreams that you have been putting on hold. You know, life doesn't have to stop. Life doesn't ever have to stop for as long as we're breathing. So, yeah, and all the best, all the best, all the best.